Hi everyone, this is Arun. Welcome back to another video. So before we explore BA Analysis Editor, I wanted to show you something which I missed out in the last episode. So we're gonna take a look at how to add a chart or a graph to your analysis using BA Composer. So I'm in the Reports and Analytics homepage. I'm gonna skip the part where I tell you how to navigate and reach this page. So if you don't know how to get to this page, check out my previous two videos. You see the analysis that we created in the last two videos. So let's go ahead and edit this one. So click on the options and click edit. In our analysis, what we want is to see supplier name, invoice number, invoice amount paid, invoice amount, and maybe the invoice date. Okay, so we're gonna have a tabular format and also a chart in our analysis. So you'll see two different views, and in the table we'll have the details, and in the chart we'll just have supplier name, invoice amount, and the invoice amount paid, and the table will have all the other details. So I'm gonna remove description, highlight the field, click the remove button, and then I'm gonna remove days, which is a calculated field. Remove that. This looks good to me, but I want to group it by supplier, right? So I'm gonna move supplier name to the top of the list. So highlight the field, then click move to the top. All right, this looks good. Let's click next. All right, so every time you come to this page, you have to remember to select the preview option, okay? So select preview. Now in the chart section, we haven't selected anything, right? So in the graph, it says none. So let's go ahead and select maybe a bar. It's gonna give you an error, don't worry about it. All right, let's go to edit graph option. This was disabled in our previous videos because we didn't select any option under graph. Let's go ahead and exclude. So in the graph, we don't want to see invoice date and maybe the invoice number. We don't want to see those two items. So let's select invoice date in the group by section, then say excluded. We're going to do the same for invoice number, say excluded, move to excluded. So now you can see that the error is gone and you are able to see the graph and the table, both, right? The graph has supplier name on the x-axis and you see the invoice amount and invoice amount paid bars in the graph. Let's do one more thing. We'll, in the group by, let's select invoice type and then select move to prompt for. We're gonna select the invoice type and the chart is gonna refresh based on the selection. So now we have the table, we have the graph. Now I want supplier name to be the first field. So let's go back to edit table. So supplier name, let's move in the column section, select supplier name. Let's move it to the top of the list. All right, now you can see supplier name, invoice number, date, invoice amount, and invoice amount paid. So in the graph, you see just the amount, total amount for the supplier. And in the table, you can see more details of that supplier and the invoice. I think this looks good. So I just wanted to quickly show you, you can add a graph. Now, if you don't want both the views, you can remove one of them. So if I say none, it's gone. You'll only have graph, but I want to have both. So I'll select table. All right, this looks good. This looks good. Okay, cool. So let's go to submit, or you can go to save. And I'm gonna change this to invoice details with graph. Click submit. And obviously you're not gonna see it because we are looking at the favorites. Now clear the filter. Go to shared folders, custom, A1 analysis, and invoice details with graph. Let's make it our favorite. All right, let's view it. I forgot to put the prompt. section for the table, we can go ahead and fix that. But I just want to show you how the graph works. So come down to the graph section, select invoice type, and then maybe select prepayment. So you can see that you have all the suppliers on the x-axis and the corresponding invoice amount and invoice amount paid by that supplier. So this is how you can add a chart to the analysis. Now let's do one thing. Let's go back and I'm going to show you a few more options. Select edit and select views, preview. So here in the layout option, it says table above graph. We can change that. So if you want a table below the graph, you can do that. Table left of graph, you can do that. Table to the right of graph, you can do that. Let's do table to the left of graph. So that way you can see the graph on the right, right? And go to edit table. Let's select invoice type. Move to prompt 4. That's all the change I want to do. So you can go to save, submit. So we're going to overwrite, say yes, okay. Now if you want to go back to your favorite in the search section, you can type in favorite, select favorite. Oops, don't know what happened. No, don't worry about it. Let's go back to home and let's come back to reports and analytics. All right, so we have the invoice details with graph. Let's open it and you can see the two options. So let me select prepayment. So you can see that it shows ABC Consulting, Advanced Corp, JGA, Office Depot, and Staffing Services. The table has more details. If you wanted to see the individual invoices, the date, and the amounts associated with it, you can do that. But the graph has the high-level details, so aggregated values. I hope this was helpful. I was preparing the BA Analysis Editor video, but then I realized I hadn't shown you guys this one, so I made this one. Once again, if you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you like the content that I'm making, consider subscribing. Trying to post videos every week. Next one is about BA Analysis Editor. I'll talk to you in the next one. Stay safe, stay healthy, guys.